So welcome back, and we're getting there. We're making progress. This morning, I have redone the carpeting on that side because I had one big panel down there of plywood, which kind of was too far out. It sort of met up with the edge of this spar here in the, what would it be, ABC pillar. And the problem with that was it took away probably a couple of inches of space in that area, and probably added 5, 6, 7 mil with the carpeting, maybe a little bit more, to the edge of that panel. So if the seat, when it eventually does arrive, is that critical for distance, and apparently the guys who do this all the time reckon it is, then I didn't want to add that extra thickness there to that wall. So anyway, it doesn't look quite as perfect, not that it ever did look perfect, but I've got some blanking things to put up there on the screws, but made a panel for the top, recarpeted the bottom, so that side's done. What else have I done? I can't remember whether I'd done the water and in and out the drain and whatever before last time we were here, but I did that if I hadn't at that point. Obviously everything else now, the fridge is in, the water, the gas, the electricity, all wired in. The only thing I've got to do now, one thing I did yesterday, was made a little, I don't know if you can see that little vent there down at the bottom with a slot in it. That's just a piece of metal that actually I reused from the van. I cut it to size, put a slot in it, primed it and sprayed it with silver paint to sort of match the rest of the area, because the only other vents that I could see were either big plastic ones that again stuck out from the side, and I want to keep it as slimline as possible to avoid, I don't think anything down there actually at that level will catch with a seat, but I wanted to keep it as flush to that surface as I could, and I didn't really want a huge vent in there. And behind that I've got the mains charger for the lithium phosphate battery, and I've also got the compressor that belongs to that fridge there. So that was a job. Actually, believe it or not, making that little bracket took me about 2 hours, because I had to do it drilling a series of holes, then with a hand file I had to cut out or file out and make it smooth on either side to make it into a slot. So that was quite a bit of work. Pile of offcuts of carpet there, the odd pencil, Stanley knife, and bits and pieces kicking around at the van. Also this morning I made the, if I can just get around here so you can see them, I made the two little, in driftwood, the two little back panels that go behind the seats, and put the T-trim around them. For the one on the left hand side, I had to cut out part of the plastic, of the plastic trim that goes on the back. There's like a bit of a kind of a concave bit that goes inside, and that takes up quite a big chunk of space where now the battery is under the passenger seat there, and at some point either the diesel heater, or at least the pipework for the diesel heater, will come out of the under driver's seat position. So that'll either just need a hole cutting in it or whatever, depending on who does that for me, because I'm not going to do that myself. I'm going to get that done, I think. So made those two panels, did that little vent, recarpeted this side. I mean, really the van just needs a very good cleaning out. It's full of dog hair, full of bits of sawdust and God knows what. I'll have to get some sort of attachment for the vac that gets into those rails, because they get full of all sorts of bits of crap. And then now the only thing left is I've got to take that passenger seat back out and connect the wire that I ran from the mains battery charger to that battery, and then just test out the mains electric again, seeing as I've rewired everything up. I've got a couple of sockets there in that panel. I've got a couple of sockets around the side of there in that panel. So four sockets is enough in a van of this size. The ones up there are on a 32 amp fuse. And the ones in there, I think, are on a 16 amp fuse. And then I've wired the mains charger up, sorry, the mains battery charger up on its own independent fuse. And at the minute, I've got all sorts of bits of wires. If I can just get that little wardrobe open, I've got all sorts of bits of wires that I've got to sort of conduit it off somehow. So I'll have to make a little sort of corner panel to hide those there. I made that back panel there. Well, actually, that came with the unit, so I put that back panel behind and then ran the wires down, and all the fuse box for the mains electric is in there. It's a bit dark, isn't it? I don't know if you can quite see in there. That might be a little bit better. So yes, I've got a bit of diddling to do to I can get wires to sort of hide them away a little bit. But all in all, apart from sorting that battery connection out now and doing the apart from sorting that battery connection out and doing the other bits and pieces to sort those wires out, clean it up, get it ready, we're sort of then ready for the seat, because the next job, and I did that shelf, which I think you saw before, and put some lights in. But again, the wires at the top of that shelf all have to be hidden away, and at this minute they're not. So I've got an LED light that runs under here, under this bar here, an LED light that sits under there, and then there's an LED strip like that. And at night time it does look quite good. And the one at the bottom, I went for a softer glowing one to try and balance out that really sort of bright daylighty kind of look that all of the other LEDs have. And then I've got that little kind of gooseneck spot lamp over there, which is a softer white light as well. So yeah, it is coming on. I do need that seat now though to really make any more progress, because once I've sorted that battery out and tidied up those little bits of wire that are kicking about, I need to make a seat drawer that goes under that seat, and like a sort of a panel either side. Again, I'm going to do that out of driftwood, so it's got a balance of the sort of driftwood look with that top shelf, with those little back panels there, with the seat box. And then later on I'm going to make a box that goes across the top, but that'll have like a door in it, so that'll be more like a little kind of locker effect that goes across the top of the back, just for a tiny bit more storage. And I'm probably, rather than keeping a little chemical toilet in that cupboard down there, I am going to probably make a little box that sits just here behind the passenger seat, which is also a stool, so that because I'm not having a pop top on this, it just gives me the ability to sit somewhere without having to pull that full seat forward. Because my plan is that when I'm using the van, if I get to a campsite, I'll just push that seat right to the very back and give myself as much space here as I can do, and then probably get the table that fits into the seat itself with a bar on and the thingamabob, so that I can sit and eat down there. Then I will probably get a stooly type thing that I can move around. I'll put some of this liner carpet, I think, on the base of it, so it's soft against this floor, so it doesn't in any way scratch it. And then I can just move that around, have the toilet hidden in it, and keep it sort of fairly quite sealed as well, to try and, you know, if there are any sort of odors or anything coming from the loo, as you sometimes get with these chemical toilets, then that will be like, the toilet will seal it, but also that box will give it like a second seal. So then at that point, when all of those things are done, and maybe before all of those things are done, I've got a couple of weeks off work in August. I'm just now planning and hoping that the seat arrives. When it does eventually arrive, I will do like a bit of a full walk around of the van. I'm not going to do any more exterior styling this year because it's just too expensive. Can't afford it. I've spent an absolute bloody fortune on this van already. When that seat goes in, I need to shell out another 6.5 grand, I think it is. So, yes, it will be wallet sealed for the rest of this year, I think. Try and get away and enjoy the van maybe in August and then perhaps a weekend or two in September. And just get to enjoy it a little bit. Get to learn all of the little bits and pieces that need tweaking and how to pack for camping and all that stuff again, because it's been quite a fair few years since I went away in a van. See how Archie the little puppy does as he gets used to it. Hopefully doesn't chew all this furniture. And then just go away and, as I say, have a bit of fun and see how it all goes. So I will come back possibly in another video when I get the seat. I'm not sure there's going to be a great deal more happening between now and then. And that's just a bit of a waiting game. As I record this video now, we're on the 16th of July, Friday the 16th of July. And one of the guys said he thought there's a good chance of me having the seat before the end of July. The other guy said not a chance, it could be November. So who knows? Absolutely no idea when this seat's going to arrive. Right then, thanks for watching. Take care of yourselves. If you're going on holiday in your own camper vans, enjoy yourselves. If you're thinking of building one, good luck with everything and take care of yourselves. Bye for now.